It's incredible how tightly they packed the boats in the shipyard. It's half empty now, as many have gone out, but yeah, it's just really packed in like sardines. And ready to go on the water, a bit of tidying up to do.
Just beautiful. Rhodes, Greece. And here it is successfully docked, and everyone's getting off. Cars, people.
Stephen and Kerry. Together, we're pursuing our dream to sail around the world on our 37-foot yacht, Thankfulness. Our mission is to inspire, encourage, and bring hope as we share the adventure along the way. We barely know where to start, but Kerry's going to have a crack at getting all of the food organised in the galley.
Yeah.
And there's basically no floor space anywhere. And I'm going to try and get the tool shed sorted out. So I've commandeered this cabin here, and it's in complete disarray. But I'm the Tetris master, so it'll be like Doctor Who's TARDIS. We'll just keep putting things in and the space will increase. I'll let you into a little secret, which is how I approach a problem when it's completely overwhelming, which is what this boat is at the moment. There's just stuff everywhere. And when I'm trying to organize a mess like this, the first thing I do is say, I'm not going to worry about the detail. Just get all the same kind of things in the same place. So put all the plumbing gear together, put all the tools together, put all the electrical gear together, put all the food together, put all the sailing equipment together, just so that it's all in the one place, and then I can easily see how it's all going to fit together when it goes into whatever compartment it's going into. So that's where we're at now, just sorting through all of this mess and chunking the job down to make it a lot easier and more manageable. Okay, that's the tool shed basically done. The first pass anyway. I've just finished the first pass over the starboard side of the boat. Sanding. There's a lot of touch up to do, but it's a great feeling to get to the other end. I think it's taken me 4 or 5 days. I did learn something though. If you have the rotary sander on really slowly, it doesn't cut very well. So I sped it up a little bit and it's going a lot faster now. So hopefully the port side won't take 4 or 5 days.
So was that a happy dance you were doing?
That was a happy dance. Today, I'm replacing all of the seacocks on the boat. There are 16 of them. And here we've got one here. And the reason I'm replacing them is because many of the valve handles don't work, they're stuck, some of them are broken, there's evidence of corrosion, and a final test when we come to the outside, there are two knobs inside the seacock fitting, the through hull, and I can use this makeshift device to see if there's any movement in the seacock. And when I turn it, even one-handed, I can see that there's some movement, which means that the seal is breaking down and at some point it's going to fail, risking the boat sinking. So we're just going to be safe and replace them all. And with brand new seacocks, we should be quite comfortable with 5 to 7 years life out of them.
Wonderful. You're doing a fabulous job, Kerry.
Really?
Nearly finished one side.
I've still got a lot down there to do.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'm getting there. There's only
lunchtime yet. Yeah, well done.
I thought I was done sanding. Not so.
What are you doing?
I'm preparing area for some black glitter.
He's also preparing himself for black glitter paint.
I insisted on black. Kerry agreed, so long as it glitters.
Well, that's fair, isn't it?
Yep.
Perfect.
We just found the road swimming complex, but it's only for very advanced swimmers because it's complex.
I think I'll have to stick to the ocean. Wow, look at this. I don't know if you can see right around there.
Oh, goodness.
Beach umbrellas. Wow.
Australia may have very many sandy beaches, but Greece has beach chairs. Lots of pebbles.
And so you pay for your beach chair. This guy's here to collect money. What are you doing, Stephen?
We're making the boat pretty.
Oh, that's good.
Fixing up a lot of the cracks and chips in the dog boat.
Oh, wonderful. That also stops it sinking, right?
Yeah. There are many, many, many chips and bumps in the gel coat like this. So we're going to have a crack at repairing them. And step one is the sand. So I've got some 80 grit sandpaper and just smoothing it up, getting rid of all the rough edges. Buffing discs gets full of the cutting compound by the end of the day. So we take it home each day, wash it out, make it completely clean, but it takes quite a while to dry. So if it's not dry by the morning, a quick and easy way of drying it is to run it and squeeze the water out by pushing some wood against it like this. Before we know it, we've got a dry pad ready for another day of buffing. As we get used to the boat, it's a journey of discovery, one system at a time. What have we discovered just now, Kerry? Well, this morning we discovered that our water pump on the engine was cactus. And getting things done in Greece is never easy. But here it is, 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Went to an amazing metal shop, got it welded up, got everything inside replaced. And they did a great job, €140. Incredible.
very happy with that. Looks like we might have an engine after all.
And listen to that purr. Come and have a look. There she is.
The main seawater strainer needed a really good clean out, which we've done, and in the process the seals disintegrated. So there was one at the top here, which we're able to get a replacement for, so that's great. But the two, one at the top and one at the bottom of the perspex, not replaceable. There they are there. So I've got to make some.
Because the fuel's been in the boat for 3 years while it's been sitting on the hard, we really need to give it a clean, because sometimes it gets water, diesel bug.
Water near. Take care always. Always very bad, but you have to take care always, always. The entrance of diesel and the water, they are near. So always want your supply full of water, take care. And it's, you have to take care more than water, okay?
Check, check, check.
Yeah. If we put a diesel in the water,
we can clean it.
We can clean it easy. And if we put the water in the diesel,
this beautiful bahinia, or butterfly tree. This is my nana's favourite, and this is just beautiful. We're heading into the old town of Rhodes.
Aphroditus.
There's a handsome man at the other end holding some spoons. Oh, he's my husband. There was a handsome man up here. There he is. My beautiful husband. What's in behind us, Stephen? Is this the museum? That's for another day, I think. Wonderful thing about having limited room on the boat is that you can't contain it all, so you can't buy it. Is that good, Stephen? Another exciting moment.
Wow. Wow. Did you get some breakfast in the morning?
I did.
I fed him eggs, so yeah, he's good. Shiny. Wow.
Set ice
cold
power.
Woohoo! And this is why Stephen doesn't need to go to the gym. Because all day he's lifting things.
We've I've got 65 meters of chain, but I really wanted 100 meters, so we're able to get an extra 28. That's what they had in the shop, and we need to join the old with the new. So this is how we're going to do it. The old chain's on the left, the new chain's on the right, and we have this chain joiner, which is two halves, and basically each of these little pins we position on a hard surface, get a nice hefty hammer, and whack, 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 until it's fully secure. We're in the process of restoring our chain. So we've added our extra 30 meters on, and we've just laid it out in 10 meter runs, and we're going to spray paint new markings so that we know how much chain we're putting out. So it's a red and a white.
Is it moving in the same?
Kerry's hard at work. Doing a great job there, Kerry.
Just gonna baste in the gleam from the stainless steel.
Before and after. Wow, it's like a new boat. But every side's a good side. So our new Macintosh came with a good bunch of fenders, but unfortunately most of them look like that, which is not going to fender much at all. So just trying to resurrect what I can. Got two good ones. And we just basically put this into the little valve and press, and some of them have a screw plug, but essentially it's the same concept. So if I unwind that, see what happens. There it goes.
And the fenders are really important when you're going into dock. They're your protection between you and the dock, or you and other boats.
Kerry, you're in charge of all things shiny. You're doing a great job on the propeller.
Yes.
Using your wet and dry
sandpaper.
Sandpaper. I think you're using 800 grit.
Yep, and then 1000.
And then the other side, which you haven't done yet.
I cleaned it, but I haven't shined it.
So it's quite dull.
Why do we make things shiny?
Not sure. Because it makes us feel good. Amazing. Whoa. It's really good that we've got a spray hood, but it needs a little bit of work. That's supposed to be joined together. So I'm going to take it off, see if it's redeemable, and repair it or replace it. Before we can take the boat from Greece to Turkey, we have to hook up the holding tank. When we bought the boat, we were told it had a holding tank, and one would assume that it was working, connected, but it was not only working, it wasn't even connected. There were no pipes other than the one that went into a bulkhead and stopped, making it appear that it was connected. Anyway, I'm in the throes of installing all the plumbing for the holding tank and the discharge and the macerator pump. And oh, it's so difficult. In confined spaces with big pipes, I've got my mud map, which way up, that way up, of how I'm hooking it all up, which I got out of an excellent book, Electrical and Mechanical Engineering for Boats, and also some advice from a local expert shipwright and in the throes of it now. A lot better than it was. As Kerry was painting the primer onto the rudder, she noticed a big chunk out of the bottom, and now we have to repair it. So let's have a look. Ooh-wee. That's not looking great. So I'm going to grind away all that loose top section and then we'll make a repair, make it nice and strong.
Yep.
So this is all the damage underneath the rudder which hasn't been repaired properly, and chunks are just falling off. So imagine if that fell off after we put it in the water and it spent a year in the water with just water constantly going into the bottom of the rudder. And I can put my finger under here. It's a really dodgy repair. I'm going to make a problem.
Stephen always does everything well, and that's just fabulous. Although I must say I'm a bit disappointed. We're supposed to be putting the boat back together, and all we seem to be doing is pulling it apart more.
This is a so-called repair. Just peeling off.
Delamination.
Yep.
Wow.
So that shouldn't be possible. There we go, first layer of gel shield. Gel shield 200. So we've all but finished and ready to go on the water. A bit of tidying up to do. A bit of a hiccup with some details with not being able to get into Turkey, but we're sorting those out. But the boat looks great. Kerry's done a great job of painting. Something in this video encouraging, inspiring, or uplifting.